हेलो क्लास 8th स्टूडेंट, इट्स अ पार्ट 7 चैप्टर 9 डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एम्ब्रियो। एज वी सी इन द प्रीवियस पार्ट दैट द एम्ब्रियो दैट द फर्टिलाइजेशन टेक्स प्लेस एंड द सिंगल सेल स्ट्रक्चर जायगोट इज फॉर्म्ड एंड इट अटैच इटसेल्फ बाय द यूट्रस वॉल एंड डेवलप इनटू द एम्ब्रियो। हाउ द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एम्ब्रियो इज डन वी सी इन दिस पार्ट। जायगोट फॉर्मेशन एंड एम्ब्रियो डेवलपमेंट। If you able to see this diagram, then you can easily understand the events. First, you can see there is a egg which is released by the ovary. Then this is a fallopian tube. We know this is the oviduct or fallopian tube. Then after that, it's releasing the sperm trying to attach here. We see in that previous part that the out of 100 only one that is capable which attach to the which fuse to the egg. If you are able to see, but I think so that you are able to see, here is a sperm is attached to this embryo, only one. Okay, only one. Here you see the structure, here the one sperm is entering in this egg out of 100. Okay, then after that it parted in the diploid cell. Diploid, why diploid? The two part here. Then in the tetraploid, the four part here, means the development is start in the embryo, in the zygote, sorry, development is start in the zygote. Then it becomes divided into so many cells, then again and then again, means the further division in the cells is still going on. Further division going on means till here there is just like this structure, and after that when it enter in the uterus it's looking like this one, and then it implanted in the wall of uterus. There is a site of implantation. It embedded embryo. Embedded means fixed. Fixed inside. So at the wall of uterus, this embryo is embedded. Now let's read. The fertilized egg or zygote undergoes many cell division to form a ball of cells, as you see in the diagram, and travels to the uterus. On reaching the uterus, it attaches itself to the wall of the uterus by a process known as implantation. Means the attachment of the embryo with the wall of uterus itself is known as implantation. The zygote grows and divides repeatedly to develop into embryo. The embryo remains attached to the uterus. The embryo grows rapidly and receives its nutrition from the mother blood. Means how it takes the nutrition? With the help of mother blood. After a few weeks, the embryo develops body part like egg, hand, sorry, like legs, hands, head, ears, eyes, and begins to resemble a human being. Means after a few weeks, the body parts are developed and it's resemble like the human being. At this stage, it is called the fecus. And when it shows the all body parts, it's known as fecus. The baby stays and grows in the mother womb or uterus about 40 weeks, and its complete development okay, about 40 weeks or the 9 months. This period is called the gestation period. Means the period in which a embryo develop into completely in the form of fecus. This period is known as the gestation period. The fecus get its nourishment from the placenta. We see that embryo taken the nourishment from the blood of the mother with the help of a placenta. Placenta is a disc-like structure. It is also a tissue which supplies the nourishment to the developing embryo. during this gestation period. Thank you, class. We continue in the next part.